Hey guys, I hope you're doing well. This chapter is again going to be extensive. Many topics are covered, जिसमें cell है, cell division है, cell joins है, then we have transport across cell membrane, there are signaling mechanisms. Yeah, so the topic is huge. I wish you do it in parts, थोड़ा थोड़ा करके करो. Otherwise, it is very interesting to study. Okay? We talk about cell joints. What is a cell joint? तो वो एक connection है between the neighboring cell. जैसे इधर एक cell है तो उसके बाजू वाली cell को कैसे connect करता है और any cell it comes in contact with or the extracellular matrix. यानी बाहर का extracellular fluid. This is the diagram you can see. This is the cell one. One second. This is the cell 1 and this is the cell 2. बीच में जो भी तुम्हें दिख रहा है, that is cell to cell joint. We will talk about the types of cell joints. First one is occluding, जो इधर दिख रहा है, tight junction. This prevent intracellular communication. Cell membrane of adjacent cell fuse together. The function is for stability, selective for small, or total barrier for large molecules, and it is also seen in blood-brain barrier. So this is your relationship with the neighbor you do not talk to, जो तुम लोग good terms पे नहीं हो, तो एकदम tight junction है, ज्यादा communication नहीं होता है, maybe अगर कुछ important हुआ, तो selective for small and total barrier for larger communications. One important place where it is seen is blood-brain barrier. Brain के उधर blood नहीं जाता है. There is a barrier. Only the important nutrients can pass through. Then the next is communicating junction. जिधर communication हो रहा है एक दूसरे के बाजू में, which permit the intracellular exchange of substance. It has again two types. The first one is gap junction. Allows passage of ions or smaller molecules between the cells. अगर allow होता है in cells, then that causes a rapid action potential and chemical messages भी fast जाएगा. अगर मैं तुमको space दे रही हूँ, through which you can transmit your impulses, then that will cause a rapid rate at which the impulse will be transmitted throughout the body. The next is chemical synapse. Chemical synapse is basically between a nerve fiber and a muscle fiber. It is not a direct communication, but certain substance is released from a nerve fiber and then that acts onto the receptor of the muscle fiber. Udhar thoda gap rehta hai. In this diagram, you can see gap junction. Yahan pe gap hai, so that the molecules can pass through it. Chemical impulses can pass through it. Synapse ka diagram nahi hai. Third type is anchoring. Anchoring provides strength to the cells and it causes firm attachment. Anchoring again has two types. It could be either through actin filament. Here you can see actin filament cell 1 to cell 2 ke beech mein hai. So it is called a cell to cell junction through actin filament. It gives strong mechanical support. ये हमको दिखता है intercalcated disc which is there in the heart. This you can see focal adhesions. This is cell to matrix. ये बाहर matrix है, तो वहां matrix से attached रहने के लिए जो रहेगा उसको हम focal बोलेंगे. Then there are desmosomes. इसमें actin filament नहीं होता है, but still the function remains same, कि mechanical support रहना चाहिए and firm attachment रहना चाहिए. Here you see desmosome. So they are less capable than actin filaments, but they do the same function. Right? Similarly, ये hemidesmosome है या focal desmosome, जो cell को matrix से connect करेगा. Now we come to the part of cell division. I am again sure you have done it already. Cell division here we will talk about mitosis. Meiosis ke bare mein we won't talk. Cell we have 46 chromosomes and the division is through mitosis that results in two genetically identical daughter cells. This definition is important. Exception is ova and spermatozoa, of course. Ye jo diagram hai, that is also important for you to draw. Cell division ka jo period rehta hai, when ek se do, do se char banta hai. So, ek se do banne ka jo time period hai, that is known as cell cycle. The period between two cell division is known as cell cycle. Har ek cycle ke mein, there are going to be two phases. Here, the green part is one phase, which is known as interphase. And this yellowish, creamish, white part is the mitosis. That is the M phase. First, we talk about interphase. Right? Interphase, agar tum log ne piche ka diagram dekha tha, to the green part was bigger. Right? So, it is the long phase. And has three separate stages, which are recognized as the first one is the first gap phase or G1 phase. Here, see, this is the G1 phase. The cell grows in size. G stands for growth. So it will grow in size and in volume. This is usually the longest phase and most variable in length. So depending, some cells can grow quickly, some cannot. So uska structure pe depend karega, and it is usually the longest stage. Some cells, you know, they grow a bit and they are like, meko aage ke stage pe nahi jana, I want to stop here. So they go into a quiescent phase or the resting phase, that is known as G0 phase. It is like you complete a college, but then you decide, I want to take a year break, I want to decide what I want to do, and then I want to go ahead with my life, right? So that is the quiescent phase. These people are in the quiescent phase, they can go for resting period for variable amount of time depending upon kaun sa cell hai, right? The next phase is the S phase or synthesis phase. You can see here. The name is suggestive ke idhar kuch synthesize hoega. To kya synthesize aur kya replicate hoega? To chromosome. The chromosome replicate forming two identical copies of DNA. To humare paas pehle 46 tha, abhi double ho gaya, to 92 chromosome hoega in S phase. That is, it is enough DNA for two cells and is nearly ready to divide by mitosis. Then there is one more stage, that is the second gap phase or the G2. There will be growth hoega, and there is going to be preparation for cell division. This is interphase, three stages, first gap phase, synthesis, and second gap phase. Important to remember is G0 or quiescent phase. Then we go to mitosis. Mitosis may be phases hai. So there is prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. So it's PMAT, Prime Minister At, because we usually, initially there were many memes that where is the Prime Minister since he was always in the foreign lands. So Prime Minister At, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. We'll look into each one of them. First one is prophase. Now, prophase mein wapis do phases hai. It is just a division of understanding. This is a diagram. There is going to be early prophase, matlab initially kya hoega, and there's going to be late prophase. Early prophase mein kya hota hai, jo tumko yaad rakhna hai, is that the mitotic spindle begins to form. Here you can see spike-like projection. These are the mitotic spindles. They start forming and the nucleolus starts disappearing. Late prophase mein kya hoega? The chromosome become condensed. In all stages of mitosis, the chromosome is going to condense. So they are very compact. The mitotic spindle grows more. You can see how much it's growing again. And some of the microtubules capture the chromosome, that is, it gets attached like this, right? The next phase is metaphase. The diagram of prophase you can see here more clearly. This is the spindles and these are attached chromosomes after condensation. मेटा फेज में क्या होएगा, दिस इज द मेटा फेज डायग्राम. व्हाट यू कैन सी थ्रू डायग्राम इज दैट दे अलाइंड. द क्रोमैटिड्स अलाइन ऑन द सेंटर ऑफ द स्पिंडल अटैच्ड बाय देयर सेंट्रोमियर्स. द नेक्स्ट स्टेज इज एनाफेज. इफ दे आर अलाइंड इन दिस वे, ऐसा है और ये अलाइंड है, दिस थिंग इज गोइंग टू गेट पुश्ड ऑफ, राइट. The centromeres separate and one of each pair of chromosome or chromatids migrate to each end of the spindle. तुम लोग यहाँ पे देख रहे हो कैसा पकड़ के है, फिर इधर से खींचा, टग ऑफ वॉर, बीच से रस्सी ही टूट गया, एंड हाफ ऑफ देम हैव गॉन दिस साइड एंड हाफ ऑफ देम हैव गॉन दिस साइड. दिस हैपेंस इन एनाफेज. द नेक्स्ट फेज इज टेलोफेज. Mitotic spindle disappears, the chromosome uncoil and the nuclear envelope reforms. Here, जो ये spindle था और ये spikes था वो इधर नहीं दिख रहा है, and they have coiled back again. This purple thing you can see, this and this purple thing is same. They've uncoiled, जो condense हुआ था पहले, now they've uncoiled and they will start developing the nuclear membrane. You can see the white thing, that is the nuclear membrane. This was about division of nucleus and chromatin and DNA. What about other cell organelles? उनको भी तो divide करना पड़ेगा ना, mitochondria चाहिए, ribosome चाहिए, सब कुछ चाहिए. That is done through cytokinesis. Occurs the systole, intracellular organelles and plasma membrane split, forming two identical daughter cells. And that completes our cell cycle. Cell cycle has interphase and mitosis phase. Mitosis is also known as M phase. Interphase mein we have G1, G0, S, G2. And then in mitosis we have prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. And cytokinesis is a process through which other organelles undergo division. Now we come to the topic of transport across cell membrane. हमको पता है कि हमारा प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन सेमी परमिएबल है, कुछ चीज़ों को ही आने देता है, कुछ चीज़ों को नहीं आने देता है. Here we will see कि जो वो कुछ चीज़ों को आने देता है वो कैसे होता है. ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस अक्रॉस सेल मेम्ब्रेन. द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन प्रोवाइड्स इट विद द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सिलेक्टिव परमिएबिलिटी. Meaning that not all substance can cross it. So there is two things, there could be a passive transport or there could be an active transport. Whenever the word passive is used, it means ki energy use nahi kar raha hai. Like we say ke he was passive at the meeting or passive at the party. He was not involved in it as much. And when we say he was very active member, matlab wo khud ka contribution de raha hai, energy de raha hai. In passive transport, this occurs when substances can cross the semipermeable plasma membrane and organelle membrane and move down the concentration gradient without using any energy. और यहाँ पे तुम देखो, तो this one is a passive transport. This one is passive. This one requires ATP, therefore it is an active transport. Passive transport may be एक चीज है, दैट इज डिफ्यूजन. डिफ्यूजन में क्या होता है, स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स डिफ्यूज डाउन देयर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट. मतलब अगर यहाँ पे ये ब्लू बॉल्स का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन हाई है और अंदर लो है, देन दे विल डिफ्यूज डाउन फ्रॉम हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन वी सेड दैट दिस इज लिपिड्स और फॉस्फोलिपिड्स. Therefore, anything that is lipid soluble can transport or diffuse down. That includes oxygen, carbon dioxide, fatty acids, and steroids. Similarly, there are water channels. जैसे एक opening रहेगा जहाँ पे सिर्फ water soluble substances can pass through. उसमें आएगा sodium, potassium, calcium. They can pass through the water-filled channels. इन पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. इन लोग का एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट भी है. अगर पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट से जाना है देन दे कैन गो थ्रू वाटर चैनल्स. देयर इज अनदर कंसेप्ट ऑफ फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन. फैसिलिटेटेड मतलब कि तुमको एडमिशन नहीं मिला कॉलेज में, पर तुम्हारा पहचान है, तो दैट पहचान से यू गेट अ फैसिलिटेटेड एडमिशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ समबडी एल्स. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज अ फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन. द पैसिव प्रोसेस इज यूज्ड बाय सम सब्सटेंस दैट आर अनेबल टू डिफ्यूज थ्रू द सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन अनएडेड. उनको थोड़ा हेल्प चाहिए रहता है, लाइक ग्लूकोज, अमाइनो एसिड्स और स्पेशलाइज्ड प्रोटीन कैरियर मॉलिक्यूल्स. तो देर आर कैरियर मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट हेल्प इन ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ सच सब्सटेंस. द की वर्ड टू रिमेंबर इज दैट दे डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनर्जी. पैसिव है, भले फैसिलिटेशन हो रहा है, बट फैसिलिटेशन इज नॉट थ्रू एटीपी. The next is osmosis. Osmosis again we've done already in school as well as in college. Osmosis mein kya hota hai? It's just a fancy word for diffusion, except yahan pe diffusion of water hota hai down its concentration gradient. The force with which this process occurs is known as osmotic pressure. Osmosis proceeds until equilibrium is reached, yani dono side ka concentration jab equal ho jayega, hum usko bolenge equilibrium. This is the diagram. Yeah, so example which they've mentioned in your book is ki ek side hum dono mein sugar solution hai, that is sugar plus water. It is separated by semi-permeable membrane. Here you can see the red dotted line. तो इसमें होल्स है या पॉर्स है, इससे सिर्फ पानी जा सकता है, शुगर मॉलिक्यूल्स कैन नॉट ट्रैवल. ऑन वन साइड द शुगर सॉल्यूशन इज ट्वाइस एज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड, ऑन द अदर दिस इज द कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड साइड एंड दिस इज द डाइल्यूट साइड. द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ शुगर मॉलिक्यूल्स विल हैव इक्वलाइज्ड ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द मेम्ब्रेन आफ्टर सम टाइम. Now, not because sugar traveled from here to here, but because water traveled from here to here. I'll just draw it. So the water is going either, sugar nahi ja raha, sirf water ja raha. How does this happen? The pressure, osmotic pressure, will pull water from here. This is dilute solution, kyunki the sugar kam hai. Into the concentrated solution. That is, water has moved down its concentration gradient. Right? Osmosis is easy. You've done it a lot. If you've forgotten, the Kishmish wala experiment jo tha, that is osmosis. Yes, so this is osmosis. You see, active transport. Active transport, primary bola. That is transport of any substance. Isme sodium involvement is not compulsory. We will understand that more when we talk about secondary active transport. You can see this GIF. This is the transport of substance up their concentration gradient. Active aya matlab up and ATP involvement hoega. Active transport requires energy obtained mainly by breakdown of high energy compounds. यहाँ पे ATP देख रहे हो, उसका breakdown हुआ. Let it start again. ATP its breakdown and then there is going to be transport. This hydrogen ion, you can see it is attaching itself to a carrier protein. So hydrogen is a substance. It is attaching itself to the carrier protein, that is the green thing. It forms a substance protein complex. This then moves into the inner direction. You can see, moves towards inner surface of the cell membrane. Then it releases the hydrogen ion from the carrier substance complex and it moves back to the outer surface. You see, now it will move back to the outer surface to transport another substance through the same mechanism. This is done through carrier protein, which is our green thing. Uniport mein kya hoega ki ek hi substance transport ho raha hai. Yahan pe uniport tha kyunki hydrogen hi khali ja raha hai. Simport mein more than one sim or simp is usually a group jaisa, more than one substance is transported. The next active transport is sodium potassium pump, very important. You can see this GIF. इसमें तीन सोडियम अटैच हुआ और वो अभी जाएगा बाहर और दो पोटेशियम अंदर आएगा. तो नेट लॉस क्या है ऑफ वन पॉजिटिव चार्ज, बिकॉज थ्री आर गोइंग आउट, ओनली टू पॉजिटिव चार्ज आर कमिंग इन, सो देयर इज नेट लॉस ऑफ वन इलेक्ट्रोजेनिक एक्टिविटी. How it works, see the three sodiums are going to get attached to the sides. This is the energy molecule. Here the shape will change from triangle to square. Sodium will go out. Potassium will come and bind to the sides. This molecule will again leave its space and potassium idhar andar aa jayega kyunki iska size and shape wapas change ho gaya. Now it no longer holds it. This is a very nice GIF for you to understand. Applied क्या है कि अगर excess absorption होता है of sodium in renal tubules, then that causes hypertension. You have to understand that there is a thing called sodium potassium pump. और when we do kidneys or for that matter when we do hypertension, तुमको समझेगा कि ये hypertension कैसे related है with sodium. Next active transport is of calcium channels. As the name suggests, transport kiska aayega? Calcium ka. I think in the previous video we said that sodium bahar zyada hota hai, isliye wo andar aayega, and potassium andar zyada hota hai, isliye wo bahar jayega. Calcium will come in. There is again a carrier protein like always, but it is different than that which we saw in sodium potassium. Because sabka size and shape is going to be different according to which the molecules will get attached, transported into the cells. Energy is obtained always, like always, from ATP by catalytic action of ATPase. It is also present, now this pump is not only present in the plasma membrane, but it is also present in organelles ke membrane like mitochondria. In Krebs cycle or aerobic respiration mein humko calcium ka zarurat padta hai, that is transported actively through calcium channels and also in sarcoplasmic reticulum of cells. Muscle contraction mein bhi humko calcium ka zarurat padta hai. Similar, जैसे कैल्शियम है कैल्शियम चैनल, सिमिलर टू दैट देर इज हाइड्रोजन चैनल जिसमें हाइड्रोजन आयोन्स अंदर आएंगे. दिस अगेन इज विच वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट इन स्टमक वेयर देर इज एच सी एल. हमको पता है ये नाइन्थ या टेंथ में था कि देर इज हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड. सो वॉट इज हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड? इट इज एच प्लस प्लस सी एल माइनस. दैट एच प्लस इज ट्रांसपोर्टेड इन टू द ग्लैंड्स ऑफ स्टमक थ्रू द hydrogen channels. Next you see is secondary transport. It is also active, yani idhar bhi ATP lagega, but the transport of substance is with sodium. Like I said, active transport primary mein sodium involvement was not necessary. Khali calcium bhi ja sakta hai and it will be active transport primary. But if any substance for that matter goes with sodium, then it is called as active transport secondary. It is like tumko station jana hai and some uncle is already going, let that uncle be sodium and you say ke please can I carpool with you. That carpooling is the secondary active transport. Uska petrol ja hi raha, it is not that you are passively going, energy is going into that transportation. But you are just carpooling with somebody, you are secondarily going with a person. That person is sodium. It could be in the same direction, that is symport, means both of you want to go to the station, or you can tell him that while you come back, उसका कार तो स्टेशन पे उसको ड्रॉप करेगा. व्हेन द कार कम्स बैक एम्प्टी, कैन यू गेट मी सम वेजिटेबल्स फ्रॉम द मार्केट एज वेल. सो दैट इज एंटीपोड. सेम डायरेक्शन में तुम दोनों को स्टेशन जाना है तो दैट इज सिम्पोर्ट. बट अगर एक जन को स्टेशन जाना है और फिर इन दैट प्रोसेस जो गाड़ी एम्प्टी वापस आएगा वो तुम्हारे लिए कुछ सामान ला रहा है, देन दैट इज antipode. Sodium co-transport of glucose. In this GIF, there is sodium and some molecule. Glucose hi hai, 6 aisa dikh raha hai to. Absorption of glucose from intestines and reabsorption from renal tubules. Ye both we will see again in their respective systems. But yes, so there the transport of glucose takes place along with sodium. सिमिलर हमको अमाइनो एसिड्स का भी रहता है. अमाइनो एसिड वापस अगेन इन द इंटेस्टाइन्स एंड ऑल्सो अगेन इन द रीनल ट्यूब्यूल्स. दे फॉर्म अ सेकेंडरी एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट विद सोडियम. नेक्स्ट ओके एंड इन द काउंटर ट्रांसपोर्ट ये सिंपोर्ट था. ऑपोजिट या एंटीपोर्ट में कौन कौन हो सकता है? कैल्शियम या हाइड्रोजन. स्पेशल कैटेगरीज. स्पेशल कैटेगरीज ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट मैकेनिज्म. ये सिंपल चैनल नहीं है, इसमें थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी है. द फर्स्ट दे आर कॉल्ड एज एंडोसाइटोसिस. ट्रांसपोर्ट मैकेनिज्म बाय विच मैक्रोमोलिक्यूल्स एंटर द सेल. पहले हम लोग ने जो भी देखा दे वर माइक्रोमोलिक्यूल्स. सोडियम, पोटेशियम, कैल्शियम, ग्लूकोज, ऑल ऑफ देम आर माइक्रो. पर मैक्रो अगर किसी को आना है तो दैट विल रिक्वायर अ स्पेशल कैटेगरी इन इटसेल्फ. उसमें एंडोसाइटोसिस होता है. एंडोसाइटोसिस में भी तीन कैटेगरीज हैं. देयर इज पिनोसाइटोसिस. पिनोसाइटोसिस मींस सेल ड्रिंकिंग. ये एक देख रहे हो इस पिनोसाइटोसिस. लेट इट स्टार्ट. या दीज आर द सॉल्यूट्स. इट कम्स लाइक दिस. दे फॉर्म अ वेसिकल एंड देन दैट इज रिलीज्ड इनटू द सेल्स. यू कैन सी हियर आल्सो. This is process by which bacteria and antigens are taken in, provided they're smaller in size, bigger than glucose and everything, but still smaller. अगर थोड़ा उससे भी बड़ा रहेगा तो phagocytosis होएगा. Phagocytosis is cell eating. You can drink a juice, but you have to eat a fruit. The fruit is bigger in size. This is a solid particle. Here you can see phagocytosis. It is larger. Only neutrophils, monocytes and macrophages show this property. तो ये phagocytosis हर सेल में नहीं होता है. Only neutrophils, monocytes and macrophages होता है. तुम ये देखो, ये सेल मेम्ब्रेन है, ये बैक्टीरिया है let's assume, और वो उसको पूरा ऐसे कवर करेगा, फिर वो पिंच ऑफ हो जाएगा and it will form a phagosome. The third one is receptor mediated. In this, there are specific receptors. Here you see receptors. These receptors are specific to a certain substance. यहाँ पे वो star वाले कोई ले रहा है. And then that star, once there is receptor का, what do we call it as? Receptor substance complex. That receptor will be transported inside. So these are types of endocytosis. There are a few other interesting ones as well. They are exocytosis. Endo kya tha? Andar. Always endo is under and exo is outside. When we say endogenous causes, matlab body ke wajah se koi cause hai. And when we say exogenous causes, matlab causes are from outside. What is exogenous transportation? Or exocytosis, it is process by which substances are expelled from the cells. Here you see, expelled from the cells. Substances are extruded from the cell without passing through the cell membrane. They don't have to pass through the cell membrane. Now to understand this, see that this properly. Red jo hai wo cell membrane hai. Ye vesicle khud ka hi membrane baad mein bana ke isko extrude kar raha hai. Right? And there is one more interesting which is known as transcytosis. ये क्या करता है? It is not related to cells as in general, but it will just cause transportation across the cells. Here you see, this red ball को transport करना है और ये cell है. तो red ball को हम लोग इधर से इधर ही खाली दूसरे आगे भेज देंगे. हम लोग उसको use नहीं करेंगे. Transport mechanism in which an extracellular macromolecule enters through one side of the cell, migrates across the cytoplasm of the cell, and exits through another. that is special categories. Now we go on to the next topic, that is of chemical signaling. Very interesting topic. Let's get started. There are various mechanisms of cell signaling. The first one which we are going to talk right now is paracrine. Paracrine kya hai? Basically, paracrine is a transmission of signals between two cells that are close together. So if this is cell 1 and if this is cell 2 and they are not in contact but they are close together, then the way they will transmit is through paracrine signals. One of the example of paracrine is synapse. Agar tumko synapse acche se pata hai, then this becomes very easy to understand. What happens is, ye cell hai, isse cell 2 ko information jayega through a neurotransmitter, right? That information or the neurotransmitter goes through the extracellular matrix, where the space hai. Here, the diffusion occurs from higher concentration to lower concentration. यहाँ पे neurotransmitters कितने ज़्यादा हैं? That means इधर concentration ज़्यादा है और इधर concentration कम है. Once they reach here and they bind with the receptor, उनका काम हो गया, उन्होंने impulse दे दिया आगे. फिर this neurotransmitters are degraded. Degrade हो जाएगा तो वापस उसका concentration low हो जाएगा, ऊपर वाले का वापस high रहेगा. So again diffusion हो सकता है. Correct? Now, what is the use of paracrine? Paracrine gives quick response. एकदम तुरंत response आता है. Plus, उसका response काफी short acting है. क्योंकि ये IR receptor पे bind किया, उसका action हुआ, वैसे ही वो degrade हो गया. Right? So, the action is quite short lasting, but the response is quick. Okay? Paracrine ligands move quickly and they are degraded quickly. One of the example is synapse, like we talked about, between where transfer of signals across synapses between nerve cells takes place. The next one is, next we talk about endocrine. Endocrine is again a big chapter in itself, very interesting chapter. Isme main kya hai ki jo apna cell hai, jo signal de raha hai, wo idhar hai. And the cell that has to receive the signal wo idhar hai. You understand my point, they are far apart. Signals from a distant cell are called endocrine. Paracrine mein kaisa tha? Close together. Isme kaisa hai? Far apart. The signals will travel through blood and that signal is called as hormones. Jo secrete kar raha hai usko hum endocrinal gland ya endocrinal cell bolenge. एंड इसको हम टारगेट सेल बोलेंगे. ये ब्लड से जा रहा है. इसका और प्रॉपर्टी क्या है? तो द सिग्नल इज लॉन्ग लास्टिंग. अभी मैं इतने दूर से मैसेज भेज रही हूँ तो मैं लॉन्ग लास्टिंग मैसेज भेजूंगी ना. एकदम शॉर्ट एक्टिंग मैसेज भेजना रहेगा, इमीडिएट रिस्पॉन्स चाहिए रहेगा, तो मैं इतना लॉन्ग पाथवे नहीं लूंगी. करेक्ट? सो दे आर लॉन्ग लास्टिंग एंड दे रीच स्लोली. To give you an example, if you have to send somebody, you know, who is living out of India, you have to send something, food item, what would you send? You would send something that is long lasting, it is more durable, kyunki tumko pata hai idhar se udhar jaane ko time lagega. At the same time, the receiver, jo person usko mil raha hai, wo slower response dega. Agar tum log ne 30 chapatis bheja hai, ड्यूरेबल चपातीज, वो सब एक ही दिन में नहीं खाएगा. राइट? दे विल सेव इट. सो द रिस्पॉन्स इज ऑल्सो स्लोअर एंड इट इज लॉन्ग लास्टिंग. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज हॉर्मोन्स ट्रेवल द लार्ज डिस्टेंस बिटवीन एंडोक्राइन सेल्स एंड देयर टारगेट सेल्स वाया ब्लड स्ट्रीम विच इज रिलेटिवली स्लो वे टू मूव थ्रू द बॉडी. राइट? Fast is synapse, then there are other, the fourth one which we will see is also rapid, but ye kafi slow hai. Because of their form of transport, hormones get diluted and are present in low concentration when they act on their target cells. This is different from paracrine, in which concentration of ligands can be very high. दैट जस्ट मीन्स कि एंडोक्रिनल सेल से जब तक टारगेट सेल तक जाता है, अगर मैंने 10 निकाला एंडोक्रिनल सेल ने, तो जाते जाते इट विल बिकम डाइल्यूटेड एंड नॉट नेसेसरी ऑल 10 विल रीच द टारगेट सेल. बट इन पैराक्राइन द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज ऑलवेज वेरी हाई. द थर्ड वन इज ऑटोक्राइन. ऑटोक्राइन अगेन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. वो खुद को ही सिग्नल भेजता है. द सेल इज सो स्मार्ट, इट सेंड्स अ सिग्नल टू इटसेल्फ. इट्स लाइक अ गुड किड. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, ऑटोक्राइन्स आर गुड किड्स. उनको बोलना नहीं पड़ता है कि वेक अप अर्ली, स्टडी, डू योर होमवर्क, बी अ गुड चाइल्ड. नो, दे डू इट ऑल बाय देमसेल्फ. दे आर वेरी कंसेंशुअस. ऑटोक्राइन सिग्नल्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय सिग्नलिंग सेल्स दैट कैन ऑल्सो बाइंड टू द लिगैंड दैट इज रिलीज्ड. ये देखो, यहाँ पे देखो, इसने सिग्नल निकाला और उसके लिगैंड पे ज्वाइन हो गया, राइट? ऑटो मीन्स सेल्फ एंड रिमाइंडर दैट सिग्नलिंग सेल्स कैन सेंड अ सिग्नल टू इट्स सेल्फ. इफ अ सेल इज इन्फेक्टेड विद अ वायरस, द सेल कैन सिग्नल इट्सेल्फ टू अंडरगो प्रोग्राम्ड सेल डेथ. यू नो राइट, वायरस आर इनएनिमेट. मतलब उसको एक होस्ट चाहिए रहता है, होस्ट सेल, जिसमें वो डिवाइड हो सकता है. तो वंस अ वायरस गेट्स इनटू अ सेल और सेल को पता चला कि ओके, नाउ दिस गाय, दिस वायरस इज गोइंग टू डिस्ट्रॉय द होल बॉडी, आई गॉट टू डू समथिंग. सो व्हाट इट डज, इट सेंड्स एन ऑटोक्राइन सिग्नल टू इटसेल्फ सो दैट इट अंडरगोज प्रोग्रामड सेल डेथ. Okay, it is also known as apoptosis. That is an autocrine mechanism. Yani khud hi khud ko bolega ki it's better we die. It is better for the whole body if we die. Yeah, so I hope autocrine is clear, sending impulses to its own cells. The last one is direct signaling across gap junctions. Very interesting. Gap junctions hum log ne padha tha ki they are junctions between the two cells, cell 1 and cell 2. Gap junction se koi bhi molecules ya signal ekdam turant pass ho sakta hai. To explain it, paracrine mein close together tha, right? So tumhara ghar aur tumhara neighbor ka ghar aur beech mein passage hai, that is paracrine. But your room and your own bathroom, they are gap junctions. Understood? I hope you understand what I'm trying to say here, that paracrine is still spaced out, but in direct signaling across gap junction, ekdam direct door hai do cell ke beech mein aur do rooms ke beech mein. Gap junctions in animal are connections between the plasma membrane of neighboring cells. These channels allow small signaling molecules to diffuse through the two cells. See here the process, they're diffusing across. Yeah. Now only small molecules can go through it. Huh? Large molecules cannot go through gap junctions. Small molecules such as calcium ions are able to move between cells, but large molecules like protein and DNA cannot fit through the channels. The transfer of signaling molecules communicates the current state of the cell that is directly next to the target cell. This means ke kyunki ekdam direct contact mein hai, agar information transfer karna hai to cell gap junctions use karega. Okay, and a lot of cells which are close together receive the same impulse at the same time. Sabko saath mein mil raha hai impulse, so there will be coordination. To give you an example, in march past, agar ek jan bol raha hai left, left, right, left, to sabka saath mein hota hai. Because they are receiving an impulse at the same time. That is how rapid it is. That rapidity is possible through gap junctions. So gap junctions helps in coordination mainly and rapid impulse transmission. This diagram is just a revision of all the signalings which we did. Autocrine, cell targets itself. Paracrine, this is paracrine, signaling to the adjacent cell or the target cell. This one is through gap junctions, you can see here. And this is endocrine from far to another target organ. Signaling cell and target organ passing through That's true. This is easy, okay? It's not very difficult. Only problem which some people have is remembering the name with the, mechanism. बट एंडोक्राइन इज इजी बिकॉज पूरे चैप्टर में भी हमको पता है कि ब्लड से पास होता है. ऑटो ऑटो इज सेल्फ, दैट इज अगेन इजी. थ्रू गैप जंक्शंस, गैप जंक्शन इज इजी. सो ओनली रिमेनिंग इज पैराक्राइन. एंड जैसे मैंने एग्जाम्पल दिया था कि इट इज योर नेबर्स और पड़ोस, दैट गिव्स अस लेटर पी. सो पैराक्राइन एंड पड़ोस, दैट हेल्प्स यू टू रिमेम्बर द मैकेनिज्म, राइट? So that is it for this video. I hope you've understood. There were some important topics covered. A lot of 5 mark questions. Cell division आ सकता है 5 marks में. Autocrine, paracrine सब individually भी आ सकता है. So yeah, do not neglect this chapter and it is a very scoring one as well. Thank you.